You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at ONNX and specifically the ONNX Runtime, how you can make smaller models that are sometimes faster and maybe will even fit on a phone. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about something really cool called the ONNX Runtime. I have someone special with us. Emma, why don't you introduce yourself? Tell us who you are and what you do.
Hi, everyone. This is Emma. I'm a senior program manager in the AI framework team under Microsoft Cloud and AI Group. Our team aims to make machine learning engineers more efficient through optimized library tools and communities. I'm focusing on AI model inference and acceleration with ONNX and ONNX Runtime for open and interoperable AI.
So this is fantastic. For those that don't know, what is ONNX and what is the ONNX Runtime?
Yeah, so for people who are not familiar with ONNX and ONNX Runtime, here is a graph which explains what role ONNX and ONNX Runtime play in the AI stack of in the AI software stack. There are a lot of front-end framework outside, like PyTorch, TensorFlow. Each framework has its own format of the model graph. The graph serves as IR, short for intermediate representation. ONNX stands for Open Neural Network Exchange. It's a standard format for representing both DNN and the traditional machine learning models. As a standard IR, it allows models trained on different frameworks can be converted to ONNX format. Then ONNX model can be inferenced with ONNX Runtime, which leverage a variety of hardware accelerators to get the optimal performance for different hardware.
ONNX feels like it's a PDF kind of format for models, and the ONNX Runtime is what runs the actual thing. So my question to you is, how do people run these ONNX models? How do they operationalize them?
Yeah, that's a good question. So since the beauty of ONNX is our framework interoperability, you can train a model from any frameworks and services which supports ONNX format. This model can be converted to ONNX using ONNX converter tools, then inferenced with ONNX Runtime for high performance on different hardware. In terms of model conversion, there are a lot of popular frameworks that support conversion to ONNX. For some of these, like PyTorch, ONNX format export is built in natively. And for others, like TensorFlow or Keras, there are separate installable package that can handle the conversion. ONNX Runtime is a high-performance inference engine to run ONNX models. So it supports CPU, GPU, and VPU, offers APIs covering a variety of languages, including Python, C++, and JavaScript, and others. So it's also cross-platform, compatible on Linux, Windows, and Mac. So you can easily plug it into your existing serving pipeline.
So this is really cool because it feels like it's an end-to-end thing for machine learning models. Are there many people using this already?
Yeah. So ONNX Runtime has been integrated into a variety of platforms, internal platforms like ONML, Azure ML, and some external platforms like Auroch, Navitaire. Now ONNX Runtime runs on millions of devices and is processing billions of requests in a production every day. And from production point of view, ONNX Runtime has been powering many flagship products like Office, Bing, Cognitive Services across all kinds of machine learning models, including CNN, RNN, and transformers. For model shipped in a production, we have observed a 2.9 average performance improvement compared to their previous solution.
So this is cool. I've already known about ONNX for some time. I'm sure there's people that have known about ONNX and then ONNX Runtime. What are some of the newest features that you're most excited about?
Yeah, thanks for asking that. So previously, we have been working with first party majorly for cloud side inference with ONNX Runtime. Nowadays, on-device inference becomes appealing due to growing awareness of the privacy and the data transfer cost. We get more and more requirements for extending existing scenarios from cloud to client. But the limited memory and computer resource makes it very challenging to run heavy models on client. To solve this problem, we glide to enable INT8 quantization in ONNX Runtime for CPU. Quantization approximates floating point numbers with low bit width numbers, dramatically reduced model size, memory footprint, as well as accelerating performance. Quantization might introduce accuracy loss because low bit limit the precision and the range of the values. So you need to make the trade-off on your scenario. ONNX Runtime uses INT8 quantization. Compared to FP32, INT8 representation reduced storage by 4 times. In terms of inference performance, integer computation is more efficient than a floating point math.
So this is really interesting. So basically what you're doing is you're snapping floating point numbers to INT8, which is going to make it better for space and for computation. Yeah. But how much of a speed up do we get doing this? Is it a lot better?
Yeah, much better. We have a benchmark we can go through. So we applied ONNX Runtime quantization on Hugging Face transformer models and observed a very promising result on both performance and model size. So performance varies with hardware. We benchmark performance for both base, raw beta base, and GPT-2 on 2 kinds of CPU machines with AVX2 instruction and AVX512 and VNNI instructions separately. So the original models are trained with PyTorch. We converted them to ONNX and apply ONNX Runtime quantization. The performance gain compared to the original model is pretty significant. We saw that ONNX Runtime INT8 quantization can accelerate inference performance by about 3 times on a VNNI machine. Smaller but still notable performance improvements on an AVX2 machine, around 60%. In terms of model size, ONNX Runtime was able to quantize more layers and reduce the model size by almost 4 times. The final model is about half as large as the quantized PyTorch model. The accuracy is also important in the evaluation. Smaller and faster is great, but we also need to make sure the model is returning good result. Given the accuracy is task specific, we took a fine-tuned BERT model for NPRC task for accuracy benchmark. NPRC task is a common NLP task for language pair classification. Compared to PyTorch quantization, even with a small model, ONNX Runtime quantization showed the same accuracy and a slightly higher F1 score. In this task, INT8 model can preserve the similar accuracy as FP32 models.
So this is really cool because quantization apparently makes the model much smaller, but we still maintain good accuracy. And I mean, overall, it's cool. I would love to see how this actually works in practice. Do you have something you can show us to get a sense for how we would implement something like this?
So let me take this notebook to demonstrate the end-to-end workflow of ONNX Runtime INT8 quantization. So you can use PyTorch or TensorFlow to train a model with FP32 format, then convert it to ONNX with our converter tools. The converted model is still FP32 format. To get an INT8 model, we provide a quantization tool to quantize ONNX model from FP32 to INT8. Once you get a quantized model, you can inference it in ONNX runtime the same way you normally take. So according to model characteristics, there are three modes enabled in a quantization tool: dynamic quantization, static quantization, and quantization aware training. This notebook shows how to quantize Hugging Face boat model trained with PyTorch using dynamic quantization to reduce the model size and speed up inference. To save some time, I have already run the notebook ahead of time. So firstly, we need to set up environment by installing all the necessary packages, including PyTorch, ONNX Runtime, and Hugging Face Transformer. Then we can fine-tune Hugging Face build model for NPRC task with PyTorch by using glue data set. So you can download the data set and run the fine-tune step. PyTorch also published this model for direct usage. So here we can download the model directly. In order to get a baseline, we will run the model with PyTorch quantization firstly. So here, firstly, we set some globe configurations, and then we apply our PyTorch quantization. So here, here is the model size of quantized PyTorch model. So in terms of performance evaluation, we reuse the tokenize and evaluation function from Hugging Face. So here is performance and accuracy result with PyTorch quantized model.
That's cool. So this is this is a PyTorch quantized model. We saw it go from 400 down to 170 something, but we haven't done the ONNX runtime quantization model. Is that right? So that's what we're doing next. Okay, let's take a look at that.
Yeah, so let's go to the key part of ONNX runtime quantization. So as shown in this diagram, there are three steps. Convert the original model to ONNX FP32 model, quantize it with our quantization tool, then inference INT8 model with ONNX runtime. Since PyTorch supports ONNX format natively, it provides a built-in export API. It shows here for exporting PyTorch model to ONNX format. So to get the optimal performance with ONNX runtime for FP32 model, there is an offline transformer optimization tool you can leverage to get a further optimized boat model. So here is the code how to use our optimization tool.
And that optimizer is doing the quantization for us to INT8.
We haven't go to the quantization step yet. This process is still based on FP32 for data type.
I see. So there's an optimization step before we even do the quantization step that is provided in the ONNX runtime. Is that right?
Yeah, but I would call out this step is only for transformer models.
Got it.
So for other types of models, you don't need to run this step. Okay. After this step, we can apply quantization for this further optimized model. So here, you can call ONNX Runtime Quantization API to quantize that model into INT8 format. So here you can get the model size after ONNX Runtime Quantization.
Yeah, and that's like a quarter of the size that it was originally, which is pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay, then let's evaluate the performance and accuracy with ONNX Runtime using the same way we normally inference ONNX FP32 model. So you can create inference session with session options, and then you call session.run to score this model. Okay, here is the precision. Here is accuracy and the performance result with ONNX Runtime Quantization.
So here's another question as we move along. Are there any other new features that you're actually really excited about in the ONNX Runtime that you'd like to share before we call it a show?
Yeah, there's another exciting feature I would like to share. Yeah, as we mentioned, there is strict constraint of disk footprint and inner memory size for on-device inference, especially on smartphone and edge devices. With quantization, we can reduce model size. Is there a way we can reduce runtime size as well? So ONNX Runtime Mobile is a new feature targeting minimizing the runtime size for usage in a mobile and embedded scenarios. This capability extends ONNX Runtime to support optimized model inference from cloud to client. Now this feature is available in a preview with ONNX Runtime Release 1.5. There are two major techniques enabled for ONNX Runtime Mobile. One is introducing a new optimized format we call ONNX Runtime Format, which supports model inference with ONNX Runtime with less dependencies. The other one is building ONNX Runtime with operators only needed by predefined models, so that the runtime size can be further reduced by getting rid of those unused operators for your scenario.
So this is really cool because not only are you trying to reduce the size of the models, but you're also reducing the size of the actual runtime because you're only going to export the operations that you need. For example, if you're doing like only ReLUs, you don't need to do a softmax. That's actually really cool because now you have less of a runtime footprint, which is really cool. How much does this actually help with speed, et cetera?
The speed wouldn't be impacted a lot.
I meant size, because it's the size that matters. Sorry. Because obviously it's going to do the multiplications and do the functions, but you want to squeeze as much as you can in a little bit of space as you can. How much of an improvement are we going to see with space? Sorry about that.
Yeah. So here is the benchmark of the runtime size with ONNX Runtime Mobile. The size of the runtime package varies from the number of models you want to support. You can see the compressed size of core ONNX Runtime Mobile package can achieve less than 300 kilobytes on both Android and iOS platform, which makes on-device inference more feasible to meet a strict memory and disk constraint.
Did you say 300 kilobytes?
Yeah.
That's like the size of a picture. I mean, that's pretty impressive. That's really cool. So obviously, we spent a lot of time talking about the ONNX and the ONNX Runtime. I know we're kind of running short on time. Where can people go to find out more and maybe try this out?
ONNX Runtime is open source project, so all the tutorials and examples are available in the GitHub repo. So feel free to take a look and have a try.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Emma, for spending some time with us. And thank you so much for watching. We've been learning all about ONNX and the ONNX Runtime. Two amazing features. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.